So it's a symmetric matrix. This is by definition. It's a symmetric matrix, H alpha beta. And so a symmetric matrix would have it has four independent components. However, the symmetry property implies that H01, right? So this means this is equal to this, that is the symmetry property of the metric tensor H alpha beta. Now we also recall that our theory H3 gives degrees of and how are they given? We have the parameters zeta alpha. Zeta alpha are functions of sigma alpha, which means zeta alpha are functions of tau and sigma. And we have zeta zero of tau and sigma. And we have zeta 1, okay? Because alpha, beta indices here are the indices with respect to the bird seed matrix. So they take value 0 and 1, okay? They are taking values only 0 and 1. So zeta 0 and zeta 1. So these are two gauge parameters of the theory. And obviously, if they depend on tau and sigma, so these are the local gauge symmetries. We have derived it explicitly, but we just recap that we have these two gauge parameters, and the other one was the function omega alpha, also a function of sigma alpha. Omega, I think there was no alpha here. Omega itself was a function of and tau and sigma, but we had assumed that we could also express it as 2 omega. Here this was a function of 2 omega. This could be plus or minus, I have forgotten, but we chose for it. Okay, omega is exponential of 2 omega here. So this omega is, whether it's this omega or it's this omega, so this is the third gauge parameter of the theory. So our theory has three gauge symmetries given by these three gauge parameters, zeta 0, zeta 1, and omega. Now, there is no compulsion on me to make use of all of them. I can do that, but I may choose to use only some of them and not all of them. But let us first understand that if we implement these two, then what happens? And we, for the time being, retain our choice on omega. Okay? So we make use of the two. And all right. So now, what we need to do is, leave it there, H alpha beta. What we are trying to do is, that here, so truly speaking, I have only three independent parameters here. Because of the symmetry property, I need to fix H00, I need to fix H11, and H01 is already H10. Supposing I fix it up to be 0. Okay. Supposing I fix these two elements to be 0. So H 0, 0, 0, 0, H 1, 1. Now, the other thing is H 0, 0 has to be equal to plus H 1, 1 plus or minus. Okay. So, what I am really choosing is H 0, 0 equal to either plus of H 1, 1 or minus of H 1, 1 because we are doing a relativistically invariant theory. So, the signature of the matrix, if you have minus here, then it has to be plus. If you have plus here, then it has to be minus. Okay. However, these two magnitudes could be equal. Okay. So, this I am going to here by fixing H01 equal to H10, I have already made use of one of the gauge symmetries of the theory. And by choosing this equal to this, let me call it plus minus A of tau sigma. Okay. Alright. So then this would become A of tau sigma 0, 0, let me call this minus, and then this is plus A of tau sigma.
Yes. First of all, are we not in the conformal gauge?
Not yet.
Oh, okay, so you didn't fix it. Because the conformal gauge started off fix how H alpha beta should look like, because it has to be dangerous metric.
No, now. As soon as I fix this equals to 1, then I make use of the conformal gauge symmetry. So here, this only tells me that this guy is proportional to, let me rub off these last two equations here. You are quite close to the point, and on purpose I want to highlight it. You might not find it exactly like this in the literature. Here, you see this is then equals to A of tau sigma times minus 1, 0, 0 plus 1, right? So then for me, this becomes A of tau sigma times eta alpha beta, where eta alpha beta is a flat vector, right? So, and then, so this, that means H alpha beta goes as eta alpha beta, and if I set A of tau sigma equal to 1, then this would be, if I set this equals to 1, then I have made use of the third gauge symmetry also of the theory. So I have used all the three gauge symmetries of the theory. In that case, my Wernicke metric tensor simply transforms into a flat metric.
But to say this, you have to affirm that G alpha beta is equal to the Minkowski symmetry. Because the conformal gauge is just putting H alpha beta equals to the induced metric, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you're saying that, you're stating that the induced metric should be Minkowski.
No, not really. There is a subtle difference in these two, which I want to pinpoint. Here I am not, when I am discussing this, I am not at all talking about G alpha beta. I am not at all talking about G alpha beta. This is just H alpha beta, okay, and so I set these two equals to 0, I have used one gauge symmetry. I set this equals to this and this, minus plus is because of the Lorentz indices or because of the relativistic theory. So you have this signature of the metric has to be minus or plus, or plus or minus. Okay. So for that reason, I had said that this h 0, 0 would be plus minus of h 1. This is the essence of this. So I just put it equal to, I put this magnitude equal to, just given a different name, you could write it still h 0, 0 or h 1, 1, doesn't matter. So that means here h 0, 0 and h 1, 1, they are still functions of the argument sigma alpha. Yes.
Why plus sign?
Why? Yeah.
The plus sign would not make any sense.
Yeah, okay.
In any case, good. It is minus.
I agree with your conclusion. It is just to also give a margin, if you were not working in a relativistic or invariant theory, then the, for example, if you decide to work in the Euclidean theory, for example, so this just to keep a scope, it would be always minus. For our practical purposes, we are always doing relativistic theories. In the relativistic context, it has to be minus of this. So we agree, right? Good. So I simply called it A. So minus A and then plus A. This is fine. And then I set this A of tau sigma equals to 1. So this simply implied that my H was proportional to the flat metric. Obviously, as long as I do not set A of tau sigma equals to 1, I'm my word sheet metric is still curved, is describing a curved manifold. But when I set